court incorporated a provision within UCC 4A. This idea of incorporating UCC 4A as the underlying framework is similar to existing Federal Reserve services, such as our Fed Wire Fund service, which is also governed by UCC 4A. So additionally, in addition to making UCC 4A the underlying framework for the Fed Now service, Reg J also provided that UCC 4A applies to all funds transferred over the Fed Now service. So another thing that Reg J did is it granted the Reserve Banks the authority to issue an operating circular for the Fed Now service, hence Operating Circular 8, which we're talking about. An operating circular is to govern the Fed Now service, and OC 8 was published in September 21st of this year, so not a couple months, a little less than a couple months ago. So just to reiterate everything, the general hierarchy is as follows. You have Reg J, which sets the governing law and includes UCC 4A as the underlying framework. And then you have the operating circular, which sets some of the terms. And then there are other business-related documents, such as the operating procedures, which Casey has discussed, that have additional specification. In fact, if you were to look at section 3.1 of OCA, and we'll do this from time to time, we'll point you to the specific section within the operating circular. So if you haven't had a chance to read it, you can go back later and see exactly what we're talking about. But section 3.1 of OCA specifically calls out and provides requirement to follow the operating procedure as well by saying that each FedNow participant and service provider, if any, is required to follow the FedNow service operating procedure and technical specification, which the Reserve Bank may issue and amend from time to time. So when you're reading OCA, bear in mind that the operating procedures and the technical specifications are where you would need to go to see some operational specificity. Now, there are some similarities, OCA, with other existing operating circles that are present in the Federal Reserve System. So for those of you who dealt with other operating circles in the system, OCA might be somewhat familiar. So for example, the FedNow service is a funds transfer service. So in that way, we are similar to our FedWire fund service, and we draw upon operating circular 6, which controls the FedWire fund service. Also, we draw upon OC1, and OC1 deals with account relationship and applies to our payment services. Finally, we also draw from OC5, and OC5 deals with electronic access to our services, so it will also be applicable. Now, this is because the FedNow service is the payment service, right? So it will need to have electronic accesses,